Punya, PL Punya.
Yeah, PL Punya. They were talking about Arakshan, they went around and there was a big Dalit movement, Dalit maids coming forward and saying that Arakshan has banned this Arakshan. And Ambedkar cartoon.
The movie?
Yeah, Arakshan movie. There was a big protest.
The cartoon controversy.
Cartoon controversy, I don't oppose that way they responded. But what is this all happening? And there also, for example, in Ambedkar cartoon issue, I suppose, if I'm not wrong, it was completely Dalit maids were dominant. So I'm saying that, why, where are the Dalit women? What are they thinking about, in your perspective as a woman, as a Dalit woman? Why, when you say that there are various good women who come as an activist, why can't they become a leader? What are the Dalit males doing in your perspective?
See, in my opinion, it is not an unknown fact that the Dalit movement and many other social movements have predominantly been male dominated, and that is the structure with which this whole society is operating, and it's clearly reflected within the movement also. Many times we as Dalit women have opposed this and really got upset. The fact that many programs, you also must have been to, the stage will be all Dalit men with the mics, and we say mic and munch, like in Hindi, the mic and stage combination is all the men are sitting, and if you look down and you see the whole audience, or it's a rally or whatever, it will be all the women with the children, with the this, they'll all be sitting as the audience, and it is these men who have always addressed us. That is why today we are seeing a serious dearth of strong Dalit women's voices in every discourse of Dalit rights in India or wherever that matter is. We have had senior Dalit women leaders like, you know, Ruth Manorama ji is there, Vimal Thorat is there, and but ultimately, definitely the movement has been predominantly held within the Dalit men. Now, definitely in my opinion, I believe strongly that the tide has to change, and it is definitely changing. My work with the All India Dalit Mahila Adhikar Manch, I can tell you that in every state, very much active Dalit women are coming now, and it's they're just emerging so strongly that ultimately that whole status quo is definitely going to change. I just want to appeal actually to all the Dalit leaders that it is not a Dalit man issue or a Dalit woman issue or a Dalit woman's rape is something that I have to deal with. Being a Dalit woman and some other mass violence or some other discrimination issue you will deal with because it's a man issue, it's not a gender issue. No. I think we have to first of all break that thing. That Dalit women, we are 50% of the Dalit population is we. And we are again more vulnerable to violence and abuse and discrimination. So ultimately, if you're saying that you're working for Dalit rights, you are definitely working for Dalit women also, and that doesn't mean that it is my mandate or the women's mandate to work on the Dalit women issues. I feel that until and unless all of us within the movement, our Dalit brothers and other women, if we don't come together, we cannot afford to split among ourselves on this. No, we have to come together. Because why I'm saying this is because there are other people, non-Dalits and other people who are watching from outside. No, they will bring in this kind of issues, and they think that, you know, anyway you people are only having a lot of problems. So we have to work within ourselves that no, this is our issue, this is our community issue, and it is not. We have to find ways to address this gap. And I really think it's a serious question. But the energy, and for me the hope is that whatever fragmentations or whatever has emerged within the Dalit civil society in the past decades, really I think the women have the power to make it much more strong. We have to give energy and time for that.
one more thing is, please speak about, since your education life as a personal life, how did you face this university sphere, where the, in university sphere when you studied there, how was the Dalit male's response? In the sense, I just want, because education institutions even now, I find very lacking in that. So I want your experience, your view on that. The education atmosphere, how the Dalit movement sees women's question, and that one too, because there are many university students who take up various issues on this, but when the women's issue comes, you know, they are very silent on that. And also, it's very rare to find any women activists either in a political level or even in a student's level, where either some kind of an allegation is kept on that. I find that's because of patriarchy, so that unknowingly or knowingly. So could you comment on that issue?
Well, the same thing, no? What I just said earlier, within the movement and the within the whole Dalit civil society, the same thing is again reflected within the students, students groups and student activism also. We cannot see this separate from the other, because ultimately it is operating in the same, within the same framework. But if you have to ask me, my experience, because my whole story only has been totally different. I think only much later for me, this whole understanding about how caste has been operating so subtly, and how as a woman, what are the kind of discriminations one faces, and then as a Dalit woman, how it is different, and engaging with the community, living with the community, learning more from them, only then it has revealed to me that anything, yeah, you're talking about education, I don't think we can touch any single issue without looking at it from this whole intersection of gender and caste. It is very much alive and it is just thriving. So I feel until we really, you know, place our finger at the center of it, then we will not know how to deal with it.
Last one question in this area. Could you talk about this, anyway, there were so many points which were talking on this Dalit males. And for surely there will be left people who will be taking up these points, may not take. So that I want you to differentiate Dalit males. For example, the Jomi woman which you were recently saying before the video. Could you just elaborate that part?
No, why I raised that is that many times they actually tend to this whole argument, you know, this outside argument. It is not our argument, it is outside people who are arguing that these Dalit men, you are the cause for all the problems, like, no, like if you settle, you become good, or you change your whatever, then all the problems of Dalit women will be sorted out. But I strongly oppose that, and I say no. It is not that when my Dalit men start to behave themselves, all my issues will be sorted out. No. So to break that argument, what I told you was that, in fact, it is our men and the movement has had a lot of struggle many, many years ago in the abolishing of the Devdasi Act, protesting against the naked parading of women in parts of Karnataka. And they have, the movement has understood this issue. Even if you see some of our literature, even if you go to see what Babasaheb Ambedkar has said, is completely, at least there is some sense of it. But I'm not saying that that justifies any act of violence on me by another Dalit man. That cannot justify it. But at the same time, I'm of this opinion that the Dalit movement has understood and has played some effort, but it is totally, like what you say, in need of serious repair. Like, you can't just continue to not look at gender and sexual violence against Dalit women and as if it is not your job and it is only the Dalit women who have to deal with it. No, that has to change. But at the same time, to break that argument that, you know, you blame everything on this Dalit man, Because that Dalit man is also operating within he is also within this whole structure of caste and also patriarchy, you know. So if you blame him, tell him you behave yourself and all the problems of us Dalit women will be sorted out. No, I don't agree to that. That's why I was telling you that no, our men have fought against Devdasi. Should they have fought and stopped the naked parading? They have fought. They have talked about rapes, but it needs to have a serious reorganizing, rethinking around this process.
Last one. Actually, in every university, for example, this audience will be focused on this university students and various other people. There are in every student universities, there will be some Dalit woman watching this video. I just, because I knew that there are women's sexual harassment which our women faces in university spheres. They don't have, they face even from the upper caste women and even from the Dalit male not responding to that. She doesn't have a space as far as I know.
They face
Dalit
from
women,
from
yeah,
Dalit
they
men?
Stay, yeah, they stay in a ladies hostel.
Mm.
The ladies hostel will be dominated with upper caste women.
Women.
And this upper caste women will never give a space for a Dalit woman in anything.
Yeah.
And Dalit males will never think that it's a women's question we have to address. They think that whether, okay, I can't address, I can't speak on this line. So in that line, many people would have so much of harassment they would have faced.
Mm.
They would be very quietly sitting and thinking that this is a way of life.
Mm.
You also might have gone the several times. So would you like to say something on this?
No, yeah, it's a very valid point you're raising. In fact, you're talking about the hostels and the kind of, you know, how these other non-Dalit or dominant caste women are behaving. When we went for the yatra in Bhiwani district, this old man, he must be 70 years old, he was telling us about his story about how he was beaten and, you know, attacked. It's basically a case of his house, which they basically wanted to get him out of the house and occupy that land. They actually, so horrifically, they actually urinated in his mouth and all that. They beat him up. He was telling that among the group, there were Jat women and a dominant caste women, and these women attacked him. He was so old, okay? They attacked him, and he's telling one of the women actually put her nail so hard and actually pulled out his eyeball. So it is actually the dominant caste women who actually were asserting their power on this old 70-year-old Dalit man. So that time they've crossed all their boundary of being woman or being whatever in their own houses, being the, what you say, the weaker one. But actually their caste identity has given them so much power to just attack. And this is not just one case. You also know so many cases like this are coming up. But I just feel that to the question that you have said, like the women, we have to organize ourselves, take up the leadership. And once we start demonstrating, no, what we are about, what we are talking, what we are asking, what we are writing, what our life is about, the Dalit men will also come, and whoever else needs to come for the solidarity, they will also come. But really, I think now it's time for us Dalit women to assert ourselves, not to blame whatever, but actually to raise the right questions that, you know, the whatever the movement needs to do for us, they have to do, and we are ready to lead the movement now. So there's no looking back.
One thing, since you spoke this, I was struck by one point. For example, Lakshmi Pet also,
yeah,
there was this upper caste woman who went and crashed like,
yeah,
with the Gucci powder and all. But I want to, every time when you speak about rape, when you speak, it's just like, I want you to comment on that. Every time when we speak of rape, we speak about Jat males. But certainly his wife also knows that rape.
Yeah.
That wife is a silent person who never comes into the discussion. She's also an upper caste woman. But even many rapes, whenever happens or caste violence happens, there is a woman which has been a silent supporting or opposing it.
Yeah.
So that no upper caste women's organization also addresses that. They say Jat males, Jat males. They dissociate female, upper caste female from that.
Mm-hmm.
So could you just say something if I can?
No, what you're saying is right. Many cases the woman could be an accomplice in the whole act of violence, as you have also mentioned, Lakshmi Peta and otherwise. But in also many cases, being a woman herself, she perhaps is also equally victimized in her own house. So that is why I'm saying, no, for us, in our case, we cannot split up ourselves. Whether many times, you know, some people have asked me, Asha, you tell whether this is a caste issue or is it a gender issue. So I just stare at them and tell them, what kind of a question is that? Like, what do I call ourselves? No, caste issue or gender issue? No, it cannot be two separate issues. And it is this whole intersection and interplay or whatever nexus you call that, we are absolutely stuck in between. And that is why we have to attack both, yeah, from both sides.
Actually, I don't know anything about women. If I see the TV channels and I follow the mainstream media, I find women have so much of rights in this country especially.
Mm.
When a bug attack happens, you find enormous debates happening.
Yeah.
Malala, there was many school students going for support. So that, how did you see that as a woman?
That is what. In fact, when we had the press conference, one of the first line we wrote in our press release was, what India did for Jessica Lal and what India did for other these other cases, no, main cases, high profile cases. Why is India silent when Dalit women are, being raped and being tortured and being burnt alive and all these things are happening? Why nobody is talking about this? I feel really bad. Like, you know, this Norwegian couple about that child custody case. Then now yesterday's news about the abortion case where the girl died because she was not allowed to abort her child. The whole ministry, the foreign affairs people, they are giving statements. People have already started protests and so much of movement around these issues. While I'm totally, I feel really, it's a very difficult and situation for these people who are going through all this crisis. But when it comes to the